film came out of a camera mounted in a Russian satellite.
It belonged to the Russians?
Oh, that's a delicate point. It was our camera. We developed it. The decadent British. It's not a bad piece of engineering. Took 3 years to develop, round-the-clock work. Can't be duplicated for another 2 years because of certain British processes in grinding lenses. It really is an incredible piece of machinery. It's got a focal length of, it can photograph a packet of cigarettes from 300 miles up in space on a tiny negative capable of infinite enlargement. You see, your American lads, you came up with a new film emulsion, very hush-hush, but 100 times more sensitive than anything previously available. And the negative is miraculously developed within the satellite itself.
So you put our film in your camera and you had yourselves one hell of a box brownie.
Well, the Russians had. You see, we lent it to you fellas and you lost it.
Lost it?
Hijacked in broad daylight. Dismantled, smuggled into Havana, and then the Russians put our camera, made by our German scientists, and your film, made by your German scientists, into their satellite, made by their German scientists, and thus up it went, round and round, whizzing over the United States of America 7 times a day.
Photographing missile bases.
Within 48 hours, they had all the pinup pictures they'd ever dreamed of, at every missile base on the North American continent. And of course, every time our camera took a picture, there was another one pointing up, taking a fix on the stars.
So all they'd need would be to check their coordinates, and they'd have their missiles zeroed in at every launching pad we've got.
If they had the film. The irony is that it's still here. At Zebra. Somewhere.